Hey everybody, welcome to our Microsoft Teams readiness training. My name is Nishant Nataraja. Today's session is the first part of a two-part course that will introduce you to and help you deploy Microsoft Teams. Just as a quick training disclaimer before we begin, this training is a snapshot of the product as of the March 2017 GA release. Please always refer to the latest version of this training at aka.ms/Microsoft-Teams-Introduction. We have three topics for this session. We want to introduce you to Microsoft Teams and its features, then outline the requirements to use Microsoft Teams. By the end of this training, we want you to know and understand that Microsoft Teams is a chat-based collaboration hub that allows you to have ad hoc or scheduled meetings. You can customize your individual working channels with useful tabs and extend the reach of Microsoft Teams with connectors and bots. As this is a part one of a two-part series, there are some topics that are out of scope. We will not be going over the deployment steps, tenant admin settings management, and how meetings and chat services work. For that, you'll need to watch our next session. This training has been updated since preview. If you have viewed this training before, you should pay attention to the small updated banner in the top right corner. This will give you cues on what has been updated since the preview version of this training. So let's jump in. Why do we need to introduce a new application for collaboration? To answer that, we'll need to look at how the way we work has changed. Over the past few years, there's been a dramatic increase in the amount of collaboration. Employees are on two times as many teams as 5 years ago. The amount of times employees spend engaged in collaborative work, such as being in meetings, on phone calls, or answering emails, has increased by about 50%. Perhaps even more significantly, this kind of work now takes up to 80% more of the employee's time. Microsoft Teams fits into the Office 365 collaboration portfolio by giving teams easy access to the information they need in a dedicated hub for teamwork. Here, people find their team chat, content, people, and tools living together in Office 365. Chat for today's team is modern-day chat that keeps everyone in the know with chat history, whether it is across the team or in private chat. It is a dedicated hub for teamwork, where people always have easy access to everyday apps such as Word, Excel, PowerPoint, websites, and OneNote. These are the applications that teams rely on daily for getting their work done. Microsoft Teams is customizable for the way different teams works, including publicly available APIs and bot frameworks. We have more on this in later slides. Lastly, Microsoft Teams is designed to provide a great collaboration experience while upholding our commitments to safeguard customer and user data, to protect their right to make decisions about that data, and to be transparent about what happens to that data. So we've built upon our existing products and services to unify collaboration into one place. Let's talk about the experiences that this has enabled. We'll start with teams and channels. Here's where your working groups and how you collaborate are going to be defined. Teams, as it sounds, represents any group of people who share a common workstream or information. At any given time, you'll be a part of multiple teams, just like how you work with multiple groups of people. Let's take a quick minute to look over the UI and get familiarized. In this screenshot, you see that we've zoomed into the top left corner of the full UI. You can see the Northwind Traders team highlighted, followed by all the channels that have been marked as a favorite. Along the very left, you see options to switch between activity, private chats, teams, meetings, and files. The search bar above the Northwind Traders team is a global search that will look across all your messages, people, and shared files. When creating a team, you can add them in any way you currently communicate with them, whether it's individually, email aliases, or security groups. If you're the owner of a private Office 365 group, you can migrate that group over to Teams without having to create a new team. The team creation button is located at the lower left corner. In the UI, you'll get to select the team name, team description, data privacy settings such as medium business impact or low business impact, and whether or not you want the team to be public or private. Every new team will have a default favorite channel named General. The General channel can't be deleted or removed. Typically, we use it for non-channel specific announcements or just common chat amongst team members. If you've created a public team, everyone in your organization will be able to find it through the Add a Team section. The limit for public teams is the same as private teams, which is currently 999 people. So I just mentioned channels, but what are channels? Channels are the building blocks of teams. You use them to organize communication around a particular topic. To keep a channel always in view under a team, you'll need to mark it as a favorite. By having channels marked as a favorite, you'll see that a discussion is happening when a channel name becomes bold. Any channel that hasn't been marked as a favorite gets hidden in the More drop-down section. As you add new members to the team, they'll get the top 5 most active channels automatically added to their favorites. Any team member can create a channel. and channel topics can be for anything. You can have a channel just to discuss design practices, talk about a product, or even use a channel to plan an event. You'd essentially try to leap all the information and collaboration around that topic in a channel. This will help new and existing team members catch up on what's been discussed. If you follow a channel, any activity within the channel will be presented via toast notifications for your rich desktop clients. To follow a channel, click on the three dots next to the channel name and select Follow this channel. There are two kinds of team members in every team. We have the team owner, who is responsible for adding new members and managing messaging settings. They will also be able to rename or delete a team. At most, you can have 10 team owners on a team. Make sure you have enough owners so other people can add members and help manage the team. Regular team members don't have team owner permissions, but they can still create channels and use everything else about the product. The permissions to add tabs, connectors, and bots by team members in general can be removed by team owners. The total number of people in a team, regardless of if there are owners or members, is 999 people. I've grabbed this table from our team's practical guidance. It outlines some sample teams and kinds of channels that could be useful to these teams. Product Team A in the table above is an example of a cross-department team. We've listed this team to show you how Microsoft Teams helps to break out of organizational silos. Now let's take a look at what the conversations will look like in the channels we've created. In this screenshot, you see that there are reply buttons under each thread. This will allow replies not to get lost in a sea of cross-messaging. If you want to start a new topic, though, then you would use the text box at the bottom. In this GA release, we've enabled auto-scroll. This means that you'll be able to watch your teammates message each other without having to scroll if the conversation is already visible on your screen. We've updated the message composer to be more optimized for text entry. We've added keyboard shortcuts to quickly make text bold, italic, and have strikethrough text formatting. For more advanced message formatting, keyboard shortcuts can also allow you to create headers, hyperlink text, create bulleted or numbered lists, and even block quotes. If you want to discuss an email within your channel, you can fetch the channel's unique email address and forward the message that needs to be discussed. You should note that the replies in this channel do not go back to the initial email thread. While you're in a conversation, a fast way to acknowledge a message is to like it. If you hover over a message, you'll see a thumbs up icon appear in the top right corner. If you want to save a message for later, then select the bookmark icon. The messages you save can later be found by clicking on your display picture in the lower left side of the application and going to saved. When you select activity, you can view your feed. Looking at your feed will allow you to see all the likes and at mentions you've received, along with the replies and threads you're a part of. You can filter this list to just your activity. If you select your team activity, this encompasses any activity in chronological order across all the teams you are a part of. You can have conversations around documents you upload. Upload documents will land in the SharePoint set that gets created when a team gets created. Uploads can start a new conversation or be a response to an existing thread. Now, each time you open the doc, you can revisit and continue whatever conversation that has already happened on your document. As you can probably guess, notifying you every time a message occurs in every channel you belong to probably won't scale. But there are a few explicit notifications you'll see when you aren't following a channel, based on your notification settings. We'll cover notification settings later on, but with the default settings, this is the behavior you'll see. If someone responds to a thread you're a part of, you'll get a toast notification. If someone wants your attention, they'll at-mention you. This gives you a toast notification and email. When you enter the team's client, you'll see a tiny counter next to a channel. This counter reflects the number of times you or your team as a whole was at-mentioned. Visually, you'll see that being at-mentioned shows up in red only for you. We've spoken about how chat can be productive, but sometimes we just want to have a little fun, joke around, or express our intent beyond the text that is written on the screen. For that, we have added the emojis you know, new GIFs and stickers, and even memes you can edit. All you need to do is click on the respective icons below the chat bar. As we all just saw, conversations and channels are public. They're available to current and future team members, but sometimes you just need to take a conversation offline. To chat privately, you can navigate to the chat icon on the left side of your application. You'll see here your favorite conversations, followed by your recent conversations. You can also exchange messages with Skype for Business users. But chat isn't limited to text. Don't forget about the audio and video calls. These features are accessible from the top right of the page. We've also included mobile one-to-one calling. Also, private chats don't need to be one-on-one. You can have group chats for up to 9 other people. Just note that this chat will not be threaded, and for better manageability, these chats can be named. Just like in channels, files can be shared in private chat. The only difference here is that the file you share will be uploaded to your OneDrive for Business account, then have the permissions shared out. Chat is great most of the time, but sometimes you just need to jump on a call for some real-time communication. Clicking on the Meet Now icon will start a meeting, but it won't call or notify anyone. You can start a meeting as a response to an existing thread or create a new topic. This complete meeting experience is only supported on desktop clients. When you're in a meeting, you can notify the required participants by clicking on their name. This will send them a toast notification. Team members can see the meeting is happening because a camera icon appears next to the channel name. They don't need to join the meeting to see who is already in the meeting. To join a meeting occurring in a channel, click on the Jump In button. But without joining, you can still see and respond to the chat conversation of the meeting. Microsoft Teams client will leverage the entire application window for an immersive video experience. This really makes it feel like you're face-to-face during meetings. When it comes to sharing content, you'll have a few layout options. The first one is this, where the content is in the primary view. At the bottom right corner is your video preview, followed by the four most recent active members. If you click on any active member, you can swap out the gallery of four to the primary spot and have a miniature view of the content next to your own video preview. Also, you can maximize the primary view, so whatever you're looking at covers the entire space of your screen. Even when the meeting is done, you'll see who was a part of the meeting and all the text-based chat that occurred during the meeting. This is great for any team members who weren't around. In the meeting section, which is accessible from the left side, you're able to view a list of all your upcoming meetings that were either created here or in Outlook. By clicking on a meeting, you can view the details of the meeting invite, such as message, attendees, and reply to the meeting organizer. You can join online meetings that are happening either in Skype for Business or Microsoft Teams by clicking the Join button. If it is a Skype for Business meeting, clicking the Join button will launch Skype for Business. In meetings, you can also create new meetings by selecting the Schedule a Meeting button at the bottom left. As you add invitees, you get suggested times on when everyone is available. This will save you time in finding compatible slots. Newly created meetings in Teams will show up in your Outlook calendar. If you don't select a channel for your meeting, it will be a private meeting. Only members with the link to the private meeting can join. By using tabs and connectors, you'll be able to customize the channels to increase your productivity. You'll see that tabs are always visible and stay at the top during conversations for easy access. This is your opportunity to unify the pieces of Office 365 and customize your collaboration experience for your team. Every channel has default tabs. Files that will get uploaded will live in the Files tab. And with the Wiki tab, you can collaborate, work, and chat all in one place. There are plenty of other tabs you can add to your channel. As shown here, we can add documents of all sorts. You can link to your Power BI reports, secure websites, and Microsoft Stream content, just to name a few. Another great service we've integrated into tabs is Office 365 Planner for tracking tasks and managing work items. This is project management light in a familiar Kanban board. In GA, we've introduced the Wiki tab. Each new section appears vertically. In this tab, you can draft documents, track notes, share ideas, and even have chat around the individual sections. Chatting about documents or metrics you've pinned is a great way not to lose the context or feedback notes. Team members will be able to follow here or back in the Conversations tab. In addition to built-in tabs, organizations can easily design and develop their own tabs that can be integrated into Microsoft Teams or be shared with the rest of the community. The Microsoft Developer Network provides detailed instructions that you can use to design and build your own tabs. Microsoft Teams has been developed with integration to Office 365 connectors. To add a connector, expand the three dots, also known as the ellipsis, next to the channel that you want to add the connector for. Connectors allow your channels to receive updates from many popular services you already use. The updates show up as rich cards and channels. In our Microsoft Teams practical guidance, we go in a little deeper into what's possible with connectors. We even show you how you can use an incoming webhook connector to create an endpoint for a channel that can be used to pull data from any application using HTTP POST methods. For more details, check out our Teams practical guidance. If you want to learn more about the connector framework, such as what is currently available or even how to develop your own, check out these links. We have also integrated bots into Microsoft Teams. To add bots to a private window, click on the search bar. A drop-down will appear and you'll see an option to discover bots. You can directly interact with these bots in chat without having to at mention them. Next, at Team Name, clicking on the ellipses will expand the team options, where you need to click on View Team. Once in the Team menu, you'll see a Bots tab where you can add bots from. Once a bot is added to your team, you'll need to add mention the bot to interact with it. Note that TBot is a part of the product's help system and can't be disabled. TBot directly responds to the questions you ask it. You can also browse the articles directly. TBot is geared towards helping users with adoption. TBot will be a great asset for onboarding with its direct responses and built-in FAQ. TBot is now also available in more languages. In this GA launch, we've introduced custom bots. They'll allow you to easily integrate into your internal services and securely issue commands from within your channels. You can issue commands such as scheduling a build or checking the status of your live services. You can integrate your existing line of business systems with Microsoft Teams through bots. If you're interested in building a bot, check out our Microsoft Bot Framework, which has a step-by-step guide for getting started with bots. Next, we're on to client managed settings. Team owners can manage many settings on top of what the tenant admins have set. They not only control whether regular team members can add, remove, or update channels, tabs, connectors, and bots, they can also manage whether app mentions are enabled. Furthermore, they can set the content rating settings of GIFIs to a more strict setting than what is set at the tenant level. Any user can go in and set their individual settings for how they like to be notified. If the tenant settings allow Skype for Business interop, individual users can come here to disable that for themselves. Let's move on to the requirements that are needed to use Microsoft Teams. These are the subscriptions that Microsoft Teams will be available for at launch. You'll need to be a part of Business Essentials or Business Premium, or have an Enterprise E1, E3, or E5 SKU. And customers who have an existing E4 subscription will also get Microsoft Teams. On top of licensing requirements, organizations are recommended to have user mailboxes homed on Exchange Online and SharePoint also homed online. In our practical guidance doc, we cover what can be done in Microsoft Teams if you don't meet these requirements. We support a variety of clients. The web client will perform a browser detection upon connecting to teams.microsoft.com. Unsupported versions of browsers will be blocked. The system will recommend the user to download the desktop client or mobile app. As you may have noticed, we've mentioned our practical guidance for Microsoft Teams a few times in this training. We've created a document that provides in step-by-step detail the key decision points that you'll have while trying to plan, deliver, and operate Microsoft Teams. There's an interactive planning workshop that helps start the conversation on how your organization can start leveraging Microsoft Teams. We also provide you with a bandwidth calculator that will help you assess your bandwidth needs when using Teams. This content can be found at successwithteams.com. You're well on your way to getting started. In this training, we've covered that Microsoft Teams is a chat-based collaboration hub that allows you to have ad hoc or scheduled meetings. You can customize your individual working channels with useful tabs and extend the capabilities of Microsoft Teams with connectors and bots. Next, be sure to take a look at our second training to get an understanding on what the bandwidth and network implications are, along with tenant-level admin settings at aka.ms/Microsoft-Teams-deployment. For practical guidance to help you plan, deliver, and operate Microsoft Teams, visit us at successwithteams.com. And last but not least, check out the product at teams.microsoft.com. We've gathered the resources we've discussed during this session for you. We've even added a few things we didn't speak to, but thought would be useful. Here are the download links for all of our clients. As discussed, all of our desktop clients can be found at teams.microsoft.com/downloads. All of our mobile clients can be found in their respective app stores. These reference items will help you get you on your way. The first link is to this two-part course. Next, we have compiled a written guide that you can use to manage tenant settings. Below that, we've included a link to an FAQ around Microsoft Teams. Finally, the list of URLs that you need to whitelist to enable Microsoft Teams, with the link to the RSS feed below. If you'd like to learn more on the development around tabs, check out our Microsoft Teams Tabs platform, guidance to design a tab in Microsoft Teams, and sample tabs. If you'd like to learn more on the development around connectors, check out our Office connectors in Microsoft Teams, and view what connectors we already have available. If you would like to learn more on development around bots, there are some great resources for you to learn about bots in Microsoft Teams and learn about the bot framework. Here are some great product videos that have been put together to highlight some key scenarios of Microsoft Teams. They are also a great reference point on how to use the product. And finally, don't be shy to jump into our Microsoft Teams community and continue the conversation with us. I'd like to thank everyone who watched for your attention, and we hope you love the product.